You know, we lived in the village, close to the Bowery. And, you know, a lot of homeless people, you know, stepping over bodies, whatever. And again, I have this memory. I remember standing on this corner in the Bowery. A car pulled up to the corner, and this homeless guy ran out into the intersection, ripped off the sleeve of his shirt, and spit on the windshield, and used this part of his shirt that he had ripped off to clean the windshield. And, you know, it hurt to see somebody that desperate to make a few pennies. And, you know, lack of seeing a bird and green grass and trees. And I moved up to Woodstock with the bass player and Ray Collins, the singer. And I had a girlfriend who lived in Woodstock, but I didn't mind the commute, but what a breath of fresh air it was for me. And you know, upstate New York, it took my breath away. It was so beautiful, and the Catskills. You know, you can go on and on, but the beauty of it really did something for me. So toward the end, we just commuted for the most part, and then I'm not sure what the reasoning was that we decided to move back to California. And that is another story in itself. Because we had to get transportation, I believe we had like a week or two or somewhere off, but we had a concert in Missouri, Kansas City or something. Anyhow, my girlfriend's stepfather was a jeweler. He was maybe Japanese or whatever, made jewelry. And he made born in May, I'm a Taurus. He made me a pendant, everything, really beautiful. And I did a little transaction to buy his car from her, from him. It was I forget what year it was. It was a Chrysler, a New Yorker Chrysler. And we were going to use that car to drive out to California. So I went through the normal stuff of getting tires and, you know, having the car checked out. Anyhow, one day, and I remember the place we were living, there was a little creek around it with water. I took some mushrooms. And I'm sitting with my feet dangling in the water. And the car was over green Chrysler, and it said, "Bunk, I'm not going to make it." And I looked at the car and I said, "You know, I just had you checked out, you know, checked the oil, and, you know, I did all these things." Anyhow, we had a conversation there for about 5 minutes, and I said, "You know, you got to let me know what's going on here. You know, I'm counting on you to get me to California." And I never forgot that conversation. Oh, I forget where it was, somewhere in the Midwest, that the light came on for the fuel pump. And I thought, well, maybe something's wrong. So we stopped, and I got a fuel pump. And we went a little further, and all of a sudden the light kept coming back on. And what had happened was that instead, I had an oil change and everything got, you know, whatever, that there were crossbars underneath the bottom of the front end, and I didn't have a mechanic take those crossbars off and drop the oil pan. And what had happened, because it was fairly old, there had been a sludge buildup on the bottom of the pan so thick that the oil wasn't getting up into the pistons, whatever, and lubricating, and blew the engine. I think I got $200 from this. We had to have the car towed into town, and we had to take a plane to get to the concert in Kansas City.